Welcome back to another episode of Exploring Harry Potter. I hope you find the topic of this video both intriguing and entertaining.
You're mad. His name's been down ever since he was born. He's off to the finest school of witchcraft and wizardry in the world. Hagrid to Dursley. Inside Hogwarts, in a secluded room, in a locked tower, exists the Quill of Acceptance and Book of Admittance, both with similar purposes that work in tandem. Both decide who will or won't be accepted into Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry. When a magical child is born, the Quill of Acceptance writes their name in a book, the Book of Admittance. But if the book cannot determine if the child has enough magic, if they don't actually use it, then the name cannot be written down. This is to determine if one is a squib. Squibs will often show up as a magical child after birth, but their magic rapidly dissipates. Their magic was just residual magic from their mother that wears off. When the Book of Admittance sees the child as truly magical, then their name is written down. Then it is official. The children written down will receive their letter from Hogwarts when they turn 11. Only once a year, a trusted, longtime professor will check the book looking for who to send the school acceptance letters to. It's the only time anyone is allowed in the secret tower and room. The Quill and the book were actually created by the founders of Hogwarts themselves. They were created before Hogwarts Castle was even finished. The tower for the book and the Quill was finished early on, so they were placed inside the small locked tower that they still reside in today. The Quill of Acceptance is believed to be an augury feather, which is odd, as naturally auguries repel water. Even more odd is that the Quill writes in ink from an empty silver ink pot. The book is made with parchment pages and is bound in black dragon skin. Despite adding new names, there are always hundreds of new blank pages waiting inside. The exact spells placed on either is unknown, though some wizards may know the spells, but none have yet shared them. Albus Dumbledore did imply to know how both the Quill and book work. Sharing that information would cause constant explanations to wizarding parents who could be angry that their child was not selected, causing further hurt and havoc. So the Quill and book will continue on, as Hogwarts says, the past dictating the present.
Is this all real, or is it just happening inside my head?
Of course it's happening inside your head, Harry. Why should that mean that it's not real?
Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I truly appreciate it. If you liked what you saw, you can subscribe and most importantly, hit the notification bell so you won't miss an upload.